All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Scott Berdahl, the CEO of Snowline Gold. And Scott, it's good to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing great, Steve. Good to see you too.
Yeah, so you've had a couple of really interesting news releases out. We'll talk about some additions to the team in just a second. But most recently, you had a news release out talking about some results from your Gracie target. And this really falls in line with an earlier release you had in March about getting good results on Rogue. It sounds like everything's going the way you wanted it to go.
Yeah, exactly. It's been great getting these results in over the winter, the geochem results to complement the drill results. And so it kind of feels like one of those diagrams of a solar system where you just keep zooming out and you see the bigger planet and the bigger planet. We had our drill discoveries at Valley, and those were part of a 900 meter trend in the geochem there on surface. And so that was great to see. You know, you can, with the tenor of the drill results we had and the scale of that anomaly, you can fit a lot there. So that was very exciting. And then with the ridge results, you know, you step out from that and it increases it on that same intrusion to about a 2 kilometer anomaly that's still open. So we have a ton of work to do to follow that up. And there's a ton of upside, a ton of potential. That was enough for us to be essentially popping the champagne over here and getting ready for a big season in 2022. And then comes Gracie, as you mentioned. And so at Gracie, the contour sampling along this Gosnes zone where we suspect a buried intrusion just lit up across over 5 kilometers, including a core zone with that distinct chemical or geochemical fingerprint of a reduced intrusion related gold system. So we see that there's some kind of a monster lurking under the surface there. And certainly the expression on surface is very strong. Gold values within a 1600 meter by 800 meter footprint. Of course, the contour line kind of meanders through there. It's not like a gridded off area or anything, but they averaged 0.49 grams per ton gold. So we're pretty happy to see that. And we're very excited to get back out there and keep following up.
Scott, can you kind of explain to investors just the sort of the topographical makeup of Rogue? Because you're talking about, you know, the valley results and then the ridge results. And just, can you talk about why that's so important to the project in general?
Yeah, so really it comes down to different exposure levels of these intrusions. And with valley, you know, not surprisingly, I hope, it's located in the valley. And so there's been a lot more erosion there. And we're really down into where we can see the mineralization well. We see outcropping sheeted veins. And that's what we've drilled so far. Ridge is also kind of up on the shoulder of the intrusion, where we still see sheeted veins cropping out there. And so we're excited to get onto that and get the drill onto that as well. But Gracie is actually higher up within a sort of a mountain cirque and a ridge, 4 kilometers to the east of Valley. And so there you have an intact top to the intrusion. And in these systems, you often have the edge of an intrusion first. Like, these aren't intrusions that have come all the way to the surface and formed a volcano. They kind of just work their way under the crust and they get stalled there. They start to cool, and as they cool, they change. And that's why you get these fluids circulating. But you get the outside edge that just, it cools first. And so when the fluids overpressurize and they come up, they basically crack that. And that brittle cracking makes for a very receptive host for these veins to form. And so that makes for a very exciting exploration target. And that's one reason that Gracie, beyond just the scale of what's on surface, is exciting, is that, you know, that carapace, that cap on the intrusion should be intact there. And we can hopefully just drill right into it.
Okay, that's a great explanation for sure. One last thing I want to ask you about is you had a news release out today that you've strengthened your management team as well. Can you talk a bit about some of the hires that you've made?
Absolutely. So we've brought on Sergio Gaminal, who is most recently lead of exploration for Chile for Barrick. So he was a country manager there. And so he was, you know, he's been responsible over the past half decade with building a pipeline of, you know, exactly what majors want to put forward and, you know, knowing when to kill a project, knowing when to advance a project and kind of having that set criteria. So he brings a lot of not only relevant geological experience, but also sort of the operational experience that'll really serve us well as we, you know, we've kind of taken on a lot for a junior to have this district approach to things. And so so having that experience to lean on as we kind of set the company up is fantastic. And then we've also hired Stephanie Hansen to help with marketing and investor relations. And that's something that, you know, we've kind of looked at a whole bunch of different avenues over the past year and still learning process. But bringing that role internal, I think, will really help help us get word out there and really help deliver our message, which is important to you know, communicating with shareholders, but also just finding more shareholders. And also with, you know, the way that we communicate and present ourselves, even locally here in the Yukon and internationally as well. I think, you know, that's important on both fronts. So we're cognizant of that, and we're excited to keep working on that front.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Thank you, my friend. Great update. Appreciate it. And we'll talk soon.
Okay. Thanks, Steve. Always a pleasure.
All right. There's Scott Berdahl, the CEO of Snowline Gold.